Okay, quick show of hands, and I want you to be really honest about it. In the past 1 year, how many of us have lied to anyone? Wow, such a bunch of liars. I wasn't prepared. How about being lied to by someone close, someone whom you trusted? Wow. Sir, you have a bunch of liars here. I mean, good luck, guys, facing your dean tomorrow. But you know what? It's not a big deal because, you know, lies are a part of our daily lives. Few weeks ago, my wife and I, we were backpacking in Europe. And when I came back home, I was slapped this massive telephone bill by my network provider. Naturally, I called them to discuss this very important issue. And this is what they had to say. Great conversation.
Your call is important to us. Please stay online and we will be with you shortly.
Yeah. And, you know, when I was able to finally speak to them 10 minutes down the line, this is what they had to say again.
Your call is important to us. Please stay online and we will be with you shortly.
Seriously, I was moved by the importance that I was given. I mean, I'm not sure whether at times they were saying my call is important or if it is important, seriously. And you know, this is my favorite one. A deo that you apply here, there, everywhere. And you start getting hot dates. All my life, I have had more than 5 deodorants and less than 1 hot date in my closet. If anyone here has a better ratio, please come up and show how it's done. It's better than what I will be talking. But seriously, this lies playing with our lives, seriously. Okay, but let's face it, it's all not a big deal. But let me today share with you what I truly believe is one of the greatest lies ever told. A lie that our mom, our dad, our friends, our teachers, they have been telling us ever since we were a kid. So much so that we started believing in that lie. What if I also tell you that to know the truth is extremely important for all our future? We are living in some grave times of uncertainty. People are losing jobs day by day. So students are finding it very tough to get basic employment. Automation is killing all our degrees. You know, last month a major breakthrough happened and now artificial intelligence has learned to improve itself faster than humans can. Then why would they need us? Is our future safe? I don't think so. And that's why it's important for us to know the truth today more than ever. Remember the date, 19th October 2017. Okay, before we go ahead, let me quickly get this out of the way because, you know, my father-in-law is sitting somewhere over there and he must be disturbed seeing me next to a human skull. This is a fully grown human brain. Now, according to Professor Roger Sperry, every human being has 2 brains, a left brain and a right brain. It's funny, I found a lot of people who have none. Now, the left brain here, he controls our logical thinking, analysis, and decision-making. All of us like to plan for our future, right? He here is responsible for planning. Now, him and I, since childhood, best friends. Like a perfect schemer, he planned everything for me. The choices schools, the choices grades, even the first experience of working in a large investment bank abroad, everything. Sab sahi chal raha tha, boss. But as Mike Tyson once famously said, everyone has a plan till you get punched in the face. And boy, I did. The image you're seeing here changed my life, changed many lives forever. And that's when I realized that life is not run on plans. Speaking of that, this is the perfect time to introduce her. Now, she is the right brain. She's spontaneous, creative, imaginative. She controls all our emotions, but most importantly, our response to any crisis that we face. Kind of like the friend I badly needed back then. But how could I be creative in crisis when all my life I had been following his plan? Speaking of creativity, quick show of hands. How many people in the room think they are truly creative? Wow. Like less than 10%? Now, this is where it gets interesting. I have asked the same question to people across the world, including CXOs of some Fortune 500 companies, and the answer remains the same. They don't think they are creative. In fact, Let's build on that using a social experiment. Beneath all your chairs is a white envelope. I want you to pick that envelope, and I want you to open it. Now, within the envelope, you will find there is a blank piece of paper and a pencil. Now, do it fast. We don't have all the day, please. Yeah. So now, what I want you to do is, I want you all to split in pairs. So if anyone who's sitting next to each other, they form partners. Everyone got a partner? I mean, I know it's tough to find a partner outside this room, but here I'm giving you a chance. All right, now what I want you to do is, I will give you exactly 20 seconds, and I want you to draw a sketch of your partner. Your time starts now. We don't have rulers and compass here, sorry. Just draw it. All right, time is up. Now what I want you to do is, I want you to share what you have drawn with your partner. All right. Now this is where it gets intriguing. Same experiment, 5 different continents, same result. Everyone was able to create something, be it a stick figure or a face or a sketch, something or the other, right? Then why think that you're not creative? You created something. Is creativity truly about artistic prowess, or is it something more? After all, for 1 million years, mankind has survived fighting the forces of nature using creativity. And even today, we survive fighting the forces of nature using nothing but creativity. This guy is my idol, seriously. I've never done this, but yeah. So, which brings me to my point, the greatest lie that I was ever told, and it was told to me by none other than my mom when I was in second grade. Abhineet, you're not creative as you cannot draw or sing. But it doesn't end there. In fact, it becomes worse. Don't worry. It's okay as long as you get good grades in maths and sci. We have it all planned. Have it all planned? Here I am standing next to a human skull. Part of your plan, Mom? Not so sure. But you see, a comment like that from someone whom you deeply love changes everything. And that's how I believed that I wasn't creative. And that's the same reason why most of us believe we are not creative. In fact, we believe that we don't need to be, because, you know, we can work hard and we can plan for our future and success, right? Wrong. It's not possible. In fact, according to a survey done on 1,600 CEOs, they have said that the most important skill in this uncertain times is creative thinking. They have rated it higher than influence, global thinking, even integrity. This is exactly the most important skill that all your hiring managers and placement companies will be looking for a few years down the line. Now, I'm standing here because I got lucky. I realized it rarely in my life, and I was able to put my career back on track. But I got lucky, and surely you don't want to rely on luck as you begin this journey, especially with so much of uncertainty and doubt. Now, speaking of doubt, I know this little schemer friend of yours, he's questioning everything I'm saying because he thrives on data and numbers. So I got some. Now, every day we get 6,000 ideas. That's right, 6,000 ideas each day, all of us. Now, doesn't surprise me, I met quite a few visionary students yesterday who get 1 million ideas after having this. But the point is, truly a marvelous creation. I mean, thank God. But the point is, we all get lots and lots of ideas. We all are creative. It's not a choice. Now, the next one is very interesting. Bigger is better. Bada hai to better hai, right? Right? You guys are unbelievable, right? Yeah, bigger house, bigger wallet, bigger heart, bigger is better. What are you thinking? You know, but the size of your right brain is exactly the same of that of your left brain. Then why think you are more analytical and less creative? A moment of thought and silence for people who do not think bigger is better. May the force be with you, literally. Okay, and the last one, and this is my favorite. It is not in my genes. It's not in my DNA. You know, my genetic problems can be summarized in this simple statement. I'm 5 feet tall and I have great hair fall. But, you know, I have a reason. The picture here, it summarizes everything that's right or wrong in my family. And maybe I have a reason to believe that. But, you know, while 70% of intelligence and almost all hair loss gets transferred to your genes, only 30% creativity does. It is something that can be acquired or coached. Don't blame your DNA. I will. All right. So I believe today we have got enough evidence to answer the question and question the answer we all began with. But it would be unfair if I leave today without telling you how to unlie this lie and how some of the biggest innovators are training and using their right brain. So here are my few mantras. First one, everyone in a day gets a boost in creative activity. I like to call it the sacred space. Now, Thomas Edison, he used to get his wildest ideas while dreaming. So he used to hold a copper ball before sleeping. The ball used to fall down, create noise. He used to get up and note the ideas that came in his dreams. I get it first thing out of the bed. My mom-in-law here, she gets it when she's doing her pottery. Sorry. The point is, find your sacred space. And when you find it, be extremely protective about it. The second one, and this is the one that separates all innovators from everyone else. They fall in love with the problems before falling in love with the solutions. Netflix, all of us know about Netflix? Yeah. So Netflix, when they saw a lot of people were cheating in the relationship, and by the way, for the oldie sitting here, the new definition of cheating is watching an episode before your partner, nothing else. Don't know where the society is going, man. But when they saw a lot of people were cheating in a relationship, they created commitment rings. Now when both the partners are wearing rings and sitting in a room, only then the streaming will happen. Cool. They in fact went ahead and created Netflix socks, which automatically pauses the streaming after you have fallen asleep because it measures your heartbeat. Now take a step back. Netflix is not in the ring making or the sock making business, but they fall in love with any problem that they are seeing around, and that love helps them power this to create the most disruptive ideas. Fall in love. The next one, value your company. Loosely put, we are the average of 5 people that we spend most of our time with. That's true. Think about it, because this is going to define your life. It is going to define the powers of your brain. Value your company. And the last one, embrace the F word. Failure. I mean, unbelievable. What were you guys thinking? Embrace the F word. You know, now this is hard. This is very hard. But this is extremely important. Elon Musk, one of the biggest inventors of our time. I mean, imagine his life, thinking about a crazy dream of setting up colonies in Mars, rockets after rockets failing, millions and millions of dollars being lost, the whole world laughing at your face. But did he give up? No, not a single bit. We'll all fail. You'll all fail. I promise you, you'll fail many times. It's our response to our failures that define us who we are, far more than our abilities. Embrace the F word. Now, when I came in here today, my goal was not to inspire you to take all your plans and your parents' plans, flush it down the toilet, and live the life of a hippie. I mean, I wish all of us could, but that's not the point. Have a plan A, maybe even a plan B, but don't just rely on your plans. In fact, relying on them is even more harmful because they say more than 80% of people are unhappy in their jobs. a little over that in their marriage. Why? Because it's not part of the plan. It's not the perfect plan. Your plan is working against you. Leave that urge to plan and let her breathe and let her create beauty out of ugly. Let her create perfection out of imperfection. But seriously, 80% unhappy? Imagine how beautiful this world will be if 80% of the people were happy and not sad. Before I go today, here are two futures I want you to contemplate. One of a fortune teller who works very hard, but relies on her plans and predictions to succeed in life. The other of a detective who discovers life at each step, who questions the status quo, and who uses creativity to synthesize success for him. 11 out of 10 times, I would recommend you to be a detective. Not only they are paid well, it just sounds so much fun to be one. Okay, time for a pop quiz, like we always have at the end of the class. And whoever answers this gets a good gift from my side. I use this many times in my presentation. So the question is, how many ideas does a human being get every single day? 6,000. Wrong. The correct answer is 60,000. It took me less than 15 minutes and 20 slides to make all of you believe in a lie. And that's how we were all lied to. That's how we were told we are not creative. It's a lie. But seriously, 60,000 ideas per day? That's over a billion that you will get in a lifetime. And you thought Steve Jobs and Elon Musk are the only creative people? You're already a billionaire. Make your billions count. Don't let your billion go to the waste. Stop lying, start believing. You owe it to your father who worked so hard to get you in this beautiful institute. You owe it to the society who looks up to you to solve their problems. You owe it to yourself and your dreams. But most importantly, you owe it to that one special person, your mom, who devoted her life and whose first life lesson to you was, Beta, whatever you do, please never lie. Thank you so much.